This is a Friday Shoes production. Our target today, I can simplify algebraic expressions using the distributive property. It's found in lesson 8-1. We're going to split this into 2 days. So this is day one on page 416. All right, algebraic expressions. Well, we're going to be specifically talking about the distributive property here. And in chapter one, you learned that expressions like 3 times the quantity of 2 plus 7 can be rewritten using the distributive property and then simplified. And here we are with a numeric expression, which only includes numbers. Algebraic expressions include numbers and letters, sometimes just letters. If you look at this numeric expression where it says 3 times the quantity of 2 plus 7, we can also distribute the 3. When we say distribute, that means multiply. We'd say 3 times 2 and then 3 times 7. Do that first. Notice that's what they do here. They do 3 times 2 and 3 times 7, showing all their work, which is 6 and 21. Then they add together. So they're doing adding second. In a typical situation, you'd be adding those together if you can. And those are like families, so you can put those together and do that. But they're showing the distributive property there so that you can do the second version here with algebraic expressions. So let's take a look at the second version right here. The distributive property can be also used to simplify an algebraic expression like 2 times the quantity of x plus 3. Now, you're going to learn that we cannot add these together. So that's just stuck that way. So the only way to get rid of these parentheses is actually if we distribute the 2. Just like we did at the top up here. So when we take 2 and we multiply it by x, and we take the 2 and we multiply it by 3, we end up with whatever 2 times x is, which is 2x, and then 2 times 3, which is 6. And there you have it. You have simplified the expression by removing the parentheses. So it says the expressions 2 times the quantity of x plus 3 and 2x plus 6 are equivalent expressions. Because no matter what x is, whatever number you plug in there, these expressions have the same value. All right, let's take a look at an example. It says use the distributive property to rewrite each expression. Well, first notice we have 4 times the quantity of x plus 7. So we're going to distribute that 4. When we do so, we say 4 times the x and 4 times the 7. You got to remember to do it to each of the pieces inside. The number on the outside gets distributed to the inside, each piece. And when we do that, we have 4x plus 28. It's just as simple as you think it should be. How about the second one here? Y plus 2, the quantity of y plus 2, times 5. Well, first off, we have to recognize we're going to take that 5 and we're going to distribute into the y plus 2. And when we do that, we take y times the 5 and we take the 2 times the 5. The 5 is being distributed to the inside. And we end up with 5 times y, because we can't actually do anything other than saying that 5 times y, because we don't know what y is. But we do know 2 times 5 is 10, so we can write that down. And it states the commutative property because they've actually switched, if you see that 5y and the y times 5. So they switched the places there. We always put the coefficient, you'll learn that in a second, the coefficient, the number, in front of the letter when you have them pushed together for multiplication. All right. You give it a shot here. Pause the video, try these 3, come on back, see how you do. All right, first one, A. So use the distributive property to rewrite each expression. Well, just like we were doing in our examples, we're going to distribute the 6 to the A and the 4 through multiplication. So I'm going to say 6 times A, and then I'm going to say 6 times 4. When I do that, I end up with 6A, I end up with 24. There you go. That's our answer. How about the second one here? It says n plus 3, the quantity of n plus 3, times 8. Well, I can't do n plus 3, but I can do 8 times each one of these items, then add. All right, so I'll do n times 8 plus 3 times 8. And n times 8 is 8n. I always put the number in front of the letter. That's the coefficient. And then 3 times 8 is 24. So there's my answer there. And how about our last one here? Negative 2 times the quantity of x plus 1. Can I add x plus 1? But I can do negative 2 times x and negative 2 times 1 and then add after that. So negative 2 times x plus negative 2 times 1. Negative 2 times x is negative 2x. That's how we state that. And the negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. And there you have it. All right, let's move on to subtraction within those parentheses. And how do you distribute there? It says use the distributive property to rewrite each expression. And these, we're going to teach you to change all subtraction problems into addition problems using the add-op property, adding the opposite property. We've practiced that earlier. So the first step in any one of these is saying, okay, we got subtraction, don't like it, so we're going to change that to addition. And as you can see, simply what they did was you change the subtraction to an addition sign, but then you have to change the number after that to its opposite. And in this case, we have a 5, so now we have to make it a negative 5. And that's what it states right here. All right, next step. Now we do exactly what we did on the previous ones. We're going to distribute the 6 to both the p and the negative 5. That's what they've done. And we end up with 6p plus negative 30. Now 6p plus negative 30 is one way to write that. And we can also write it as 6p minus 30. And that's the least amount of writing. If you look at it, that's the simplest form of that. We've eliminated the parentheses, and now we have two terms there. Easy enough. How about this fourth example here? Negative 2 times the quantity of x minus 8. Again, subtraction. We're going to change it to addition. We already learned how to do that. So let's do adding negative 8 instead of minusing 8. And then we're going to distribute the negative 2 to the x and negative 2 to the negative 8. When we do that, we end up with negative 2 times x and negative 2 times negative 8. And therefore, that equals negative 2x plus, if you remember, two negatives when multiplied equal a positive. That's why it's a positive 16. You can see it right there. Check yourself. See how you do on these three. Come on back and compare. All right, use the distributive property to rewrite each expression. So it's just practicing with those subtractions. Here we go. So we have 3 times the quantity of y minus 10. Step one is, of course, change it to a positive. So I will actually go 3 times y plus negative 10. Then I will actually distribute the 3. And that's going to be 3 times y plus 3 times negative 10. And when I do that, end up with the final answer, which is plus negative 30. That's one way to write it. Here's the most accurate way to write it. Excuse me, 3y minus 30. Adding negative 30 is the same as subtracting 30. So there's the most accurate answer. Either one of these, though, I would accept. All right, how about negative 7 times the quantity of w minus 4? Again, I see subtraction. It's very rigid. Subtraction, if you remember when we discussed it earlier, subtraction, you cannot use the commutative property and you can't switch those. But when you change it to addition, you can then switch things around. It just opens up the doors for a lot of things to happen. That's why we do it. And it's to set you up further on in life here with math, what you can do with all those once they're changed to addition. All right, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to change that to addition by changing the minus to a plus and then the 4 to a negative 4. Then, of course, we distribute. All right, so we got negative 7 times w plus negative 7 times negative 4. Sometimes they put those in parentheses. I'm just leaving the parentheses out. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing. So negative 7w is what we end up here. And then negative 7 times negative 4 is positive 28. There's our final answer, negative 7w plus 28. All right, and our last one. Now they put the number on the right side, but we're still distributing. It's subtraction, n minus 2, so we're going to change that to an addition problem. Then we're going to distribute that negative 9 to both those inside the parentheses. So negative 9 times n plus negative 9 times negative 2. So negative 9 times n is negative 9n. You'll notice I put the negative 9 first because I knew that I was going to have to put that number first anyways. And then negative 9 times negative 2 is a positive 18. There's our final answer. That's it in a nutshell. If you want to review, go right ahead. You rewatch the video, or of course, read the examples in the book that they have. We only did examples 1 through 4 for this lesson. Tomorrow will be 5 through 8. And you can also watch any of the personal tutor videos on the online textbook. As usual, this has been a Friday Shoes production.